Stetson Hatter. We meet tonight's starting lineup, first for visiting Kennesaw State. Leading off, senior center fielder number 13, Josh Hatcher. Batting second, senior shortstop number 2, Tyler Simon. Batting third, freshman left fielder number 10, Zach Corbin. Batting fourth, sophomore first baseman number 25, Donovan Cash. Batting fifth, senior third baseman number 4, Ash Young. Batting sixth, freshman second baseman number 8, Hudson Mims. Batting seventh, junior designated hitter number 1, Spencer Hansen. Batting eighth, sophomore catcher number 23, Nick Hassan. And batting ninth, junior right fielder number 34, Nick Colina. On the mound, senior left-hand pitcher, number 31, John Zizdychek. The assistant coaches are Matt Passauer and Derek Tucker. And the head coach in his first season is Ryan Coe. Tonight's starting lineup for your Stetson Hatter. Leading off, center fielder, senior number 2, Cameron Hill. Batting second, sophomore right fielder, number 9, Brandon Hilton. Batting third, freshman designated hitter, number 44, Daniel Labrador. Batting fourth, senior left fielder, number 11, Nick DiPonzio. Batting fifth, freshman shortstop, number 50, Andrew Estrella. Batting sixth, junior first baseman, number 30, Ray Harmon. Batting seventh, senior third baseman, number 13, Kyle Ball. Batting eighth, sophomore catcher, number 34, Christian Preachin. Batting ninth, junior second baseman, Zero Banks Griffin. On the mound, sophomore right-hand pitcher, number 22, Nick Durgan. The volunteer assistant coach is Shane Ovitz, the hitting coach, Shane Gerke, pitching coach, Dave Thurdo, and as always, your head coach in his sixth season is none other than Steve Tripper. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask you please direct your attention to the field for tonight's ceremonial first catch as we welcome Anthony Bundle. We want to thank all student employees for their hard work and dedication to Stetson University. Fans, let's give Anthony some noise as he gets the game underway. For your hard work and dedication here at Stetson. Ladies and gentlemen, your umpires for tonight's ballgame as assigned by the A-Sun Conference are Marshall Santos, Shannon Jernigan, and John Bennett.
tires to side in order. A couple of strikeouts. Ripping right through upper level heat. Three straight strikeouts from Logan Gilbert. Swing and a miss. Another strikeout from Logan Gilbert. Three pitches on it takes. Logan Gilbert strikes out Kyle Schwarber for the second time. Swing and a miss. Shredded some obliques at the plate. He got him. 97 center cut. And Martinez can't touch it. Strikeout from Logan Gilbert. The 2-2
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your Stetson Hatters. We would like to welcome the Lake Mary Little League, the T-Ball Reds, the Single-A Dodgers, and the Double-A Dodgers, all in attendance with us here this evening. Welcome, and thank you for joining us. They will all be on the field joining us for tonight's national anthem. And ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that if you are physically able, that you please rise and remove your caps as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem. Ladies and gentlemen, this evening's first pitch is brought to you by Florida Award Meeting Associates, the official team position from your Stetson Hatters.
Good evening, ladies and gents. Welcome to game 30 of the 2022 season for Stetson Hatters baseball. Steve Trimper and company looking to erase the taste of last night's loss to Kennesaw State to open this critical conference series for the Hatters. KSU blasting four home runs on their way to an 11-1 victory. And it'll be now Nick Durgan, who has normally been the Friday starter in his Stetson career, taking the ball in this Saturday evening showdown against Kennesaw. Thanks for joining us on Hatter Vision via YouTube. Charlie Franklin behind the lens. I'm Masad Bendion. Thank you for joining us. Weather tonight, very similar to last night. Temp-wise, anyway, you've got 63 degrees at first pitch. Low humidity, zero chance of rain. The wind, however, could play a huge role like it did last night. Last night, gusting regularly in the teens. That will be the case again tonight. Although at a bit of a higher speed than it was yesterday, steady-wise anyway, we're expecting about 15 miles an hour blowing out of the west, which is definitely going to favor pull shots into left field tonight. So, from that note, it could very well be advantage KSU, much more of a power-hitting team than Stetson throughout this season, but that remains to be seen, of course. Nick Durgan starts us off. First two pitches, a strike, and that is fouled away by Josh Hatcher, so the count now 0-2. Hatcher backing away from that one. Nick Durgan Entering tonight with a 4.67 ERA, one win and one loss on the season. That one hit right up the middle. Into center field for a base hit, and Josh Hatcher does what he did last night for Kennesaw. Leadoff single to start the party. Kennesaw getting 13 hits along with their 11 runs last night. This Owl squad has been averaging 10 hits a game, just over 10 hits a game, so far in 2022. This is a ball club that can certainly mash among the best in the A-Sun offensively. Tyler Simon at the plate. Thought about bunting, but let it go there. The starting lineup for Kennesaw, exactly the same as it was yesterday. No changes at all for Ryan Coe, neither in the batting order or in who's in the field. The only difference is the starting pitcher, of course. That's a pop-up, foul territory. And it'll be Nick Durgan who makes the grab. The throw to first is offline, though. Goes into the tarp area, which I believe is out of play here in Melching. So Hatcher's not going to be able to advance more than to second base. That's indeed where it went. And that is out of play officially here. So no chance for Hatcher to advance more than 90 feet. And I think you just saw on that particular play how much of a problem the wind is going to be tonight. That was a ball that was into foul territory. You saw Christian Pregent behind the plate, Trey Harmon at first base. Both thought they were in foul territory to make the play. It ended up drifting fair, and Nick Durgan basically had to come get it. We mentioned, of course, Kennesaw not making any changes at all to their lineup. That is not the case for Stetson tonight. Changes all over the place for Steve Tremper, telling me before the game he wanted to spark his team. Well, maybe some benchings will get the message because the lineup tonight is very different. We'll get to that momentarily as Zach Corbin steps in. We've got Hatcher now at third. And that one is foul tipped. Looked like off of Pregent. He's going to take a minute there to kind of get himself gathered up. And as you might imagine, Stetson now with their first error of the game. Durgan being charged with the throwing error to first. They were hoping to get Hatcher doubled up after he caught the popper. Didn't really work out that way, though, as it turns out. So defensively for the Hatters, you've got Pregent behind the plate. You've got Andrew Estrella at short. And that's pretty much the only things that are similar from last night to start off anyway. You've got Trey Harmon at first. Banks Griffith getting a start at second base. We haven't seen Banks getting a start here in a while. He was the preferred choice at second base to start the season, but had sort of given way to either, well, take your pick between Camden Traficante and Johan Desereau. Kyle Ball getting the start at third tonight. You saw Traficante there yesterday. In the outfield for the Hatters, it's basically the same as it was yesterday, but with one big difference. Cam Hill in center, Nick DiPanzio in left. Brandon Hilton getting the start in right field for the first time this year. Corbin swings right through the fastball there, and that's strike three. So Nick Durgan with his first punch out, and with two outs on the board, it's Donovan Cash who steps in.
Donovan Cash.
And the freshman lets that one go by. Cash entering the night with a .380 batting average. Not a big power guy. Does have 20 RBIs, which is third on the team for KSU. He's got a chance to put the Owls in front again, and he will. Stroked right up the middle. Josh Hatcher comes home, and it's 1-0 for KSU. Owls once again striking first.
Number four, Cash Young.
KSU grabbing the lead earlier in this game than they did yesterday. It took until the second inning for KSU to jump in front. They did with a five-run explosion. Really never looked back from there. Cash Young, a big reason why KSU had such a good night. He had two homers. Both of them no doubters to left field. This one's going oppo, though. Hilton tracking it. Makes the grab, side retired. But not before KSU dents the scoreboard. RBI single from Jonathan Cash, plating Josh Hatcher from third. And we're going to go to the bottom of the first with the Hats trailing as they grab the bats for the first time this evening. You're watching Hatter Vision. As has been the case all season, it's Cameron Hill who will lead us off for Stetson. The only Hatter who's played in every game so far this year for the green and white. And John Bezdacek will start us off with a strike. Bezdacek making his eighth start of the year. He's made seven so far. 3-1 record with a 3.13 ERA. Very good numbers, generally speaking. 216 batting average for opponents against them. 38 strikeouts versus 11 walks. And Cam Hill fouling that off makes it 0-2 now on the former Kentucky Wildcat. He has been Stetson's spark plug offensively, leads them in most offensive categories. The breaking pitch from Bezdacek missing high. It might be easier for me to list the offensive categories where Hill is not leading Stetson right now. That fastball is fouled away. Suffice it to say that Hill leads in most of the ones that matter. Except for home runs, but he's not far off the pace there. He's got two this season. Desereau and Hilton leading the clubhouse with three. And that misses high again, 2-2. And generally speaking for Stetson, as Cam Hill goes offensively, Stetson goes offensively. Hill with a 24-game on-base streak entering tonight. Does he add to it here? No. As we mentioned earlier, a lot of changes in the Hatter lineup tonight, and as you might expect, in the batting order as well, you've got Brandon Hilton in the on-deck circle, batting second. We've not seen him there all year. Hill fouls that away. Daniel Labrador making his return for the first time since suffering that knee injury in the UNF game about a week ago. He's DHing. Hill pops that up, shallow center. Maybe playable for Tyler Simon, and the shortstop snags it for out number one. Nick DiPonzio will clean up for the Hatters this evening, the left fielder. Andrew Estrella batting fifth. Trey Harmon batting sixth, playing the bag at first. Kyle Ball seventh, the third baseman. Christian Preget, the catcher, batting eighth. And Banks Griffith, the second baseman, rounding out the batting order for Stetson. Hatters trying to get the win tonight and try to clinch the series tomorrow with a win. That one hits sharply to third, and it's Cash Young who throws Hilton out. And now here up comes Daniel Labrador. Last time we saw Daniel, he was being helped off the field by his teammates. An injury that looked pretty nasty at first. He was basically injured on a throw home. As it turns out, though, it was not nearly as severe as initially feared. Coach Trimper telling me that Labrador basically had an MCL sprain, so they're working him back slowly. Not able to catch physically at this point, but good enough to DH and run. And Labrador swings through that one, counting out 0-2. Labrador is a bat that the coaches have loved to get into the lineup this year, although that time didn't really work out for him. He goes down swinging on three straight pitches. So we head to the top of the second. KSU with a 1-0 lead over Stetson. You're watching Hatter Vision. Six, seven, and eight here for Kennesaw State. Hudson Mims, Spencer Hansen, Nick Hassan do up for Ryan Coe, and the KSU Owls rocking the all-black look tonight. Nick Durgan now with a 1-1 count. Gets ahead here with that spinner. Mims, the only freshman in the starting lineup for KSU. And Durgan's fastball not to the liking of home plate ump John Bennett. Same crew as last night, just different spots. Bennett calling the balls and strikes this evening. And that one tattooed in the right field. Another leadoff single for KSU. And that brings up Spencer Hansen.
Number one, Spencer Hansen.
Marcial Santos, who was calling the balls and strikes last night, is at first base. Basically flipping spots with Bennett. Shannon Jernigan at third. That's where he was last night. Then stretching the lead at first, and Durgan gets ahead with the strike there. Hatters hoping to get a much better start from Durgan this evening than he got from Danny Garcia last night. Garcia struggling mightily. Eventually ended up taking the loss. Very unusual performance for Danny. Generally a guy who is extremely reliable at Stetson. Speaking to coach before the game, basically said that Danny was having trouble hitting spots, and the wind obviously was a big factor as Hansen fouls that away, 1-2. The wind at Melching, when it blows out generally towards right field. Last night, though, it was out blowing out towards left, like it is tonight, actually. The 1-2, and Hansen's down swinging. So two punch outs for Nick Durgan. And with one out on the board, we go to Nick Hassan. Nick Hassan last night got the party started for KSU. He gave him the lead, actually, in the second inning with an RBI single. And then after that, it was long balls. Four of them for KSU before last night came to an end. KSU entering last night with a .303 batting average as a team. They have the same batting average tonight with the updated stats. Throw over to first there. The four homers from KSU, the most that they've hit in a game all year. The 1-0 is hit into right field. But Cam Hill going into the gap to make that grab. Ended up being more closer to center than the right. Definitely firmly in the gap, though.
Number 34, Nick Colina.
And I imagine you're going to be seeing a lot of that tonight from Stetson. Whenever a ball's hit into that general area. Brandon Hilton getting his first start of the year in right field. He's a guy that the Hatters feel can be an above-average defender in that position. Having said that, Brandon is still dealing with a hip issue that has plagued him throughout the season. It's the reason he's been DHing and not in right field. You can kind of see it when he runs. He's still a little ginger. Definitely not as free-flowing as we've seen him in the past. Nick Colina hitting that one high in the center field, deep, and Cam Hill's there. So, Nick Durgan that time gets out of the inning clean. Hatters trailing by the slimmest of margins as we enter the bottom of the second. You're watching Hatter Vision. A clean first inning for John Bezdacek. The senior lefty looking to repeat that here with the heart of the Hatter batting order. Nick DiPonzio, Andrew Estrella, and Trey Harmon do up here for the team in the green and white. Thank you for joining us on Hatter Vision on this gorgeous Saturday night here in DeLand, Florida. Melching Field, the site. Charlie Franklin alongside me. I'm Asad Bendian. Charlie is the guy who handles all the visuals. Nick DiPonzio moving up a spot in the batting order from last night, cleaning up tonight. He was fifth last night. The entire batting order is essentially different for Stetson compared to last night. The only similarity is Cam Hill leading off. DiPonzio swings through that one. Count now 1-2. Nick, like many of the Stetson hitters last night, not a particularly great game. 0-4. Did have a four-hit performance midweek against Florida State. And he hits that one. Oppo, it could drop. It will drop just in front of the line. DiPonzio hustling the second. And that ball gets away. He might try for three. He's going to. The throw is not in time. And DiPonzio's head first. In with a triple. That is DiPonzio's first triple of the season. And it may have been the spark Stetson needed to get this offense going. That cheer you heard from the Hatter crowd, probably the loudest we've heard all weekend here in Melching. To be fair to the Hatter faithful, there wasn't a whole lot to cheer about last night. Definitely a rough night at the office for Stetson. Estrella. Let's the high fastball go by. Stetson's only run last night coming in the seventh inning on an RBI hit from Johan Desereau, who's not in the lineup tonight. Hatter's opting to sit Desereau down because of Bezdacek. Hatter coaches have felt that Johan hasn't been doing too well lately against lefties, so that's the reason he got the night. And Estrella's down, not down quite yet, though. High fastball there makes it 1-2. Hatter's looking to even the weekend series with a win here. The 1-2 is inside. Hatter's looking to win their third straight A-Sun Conference Series. The only time they've lost the Conference Series all year was opening weekend when they got swept here in Melching by Gulf Coast. And Estrella's down to the high fastball there for strike three. That is the second K of the night for Bezdacek. He wears number 31 on his black. 6'3", 220 senior from Plymouth, Minnesota. He is the only player on this team from Minnesota. Has basically been a lock in the starting rotation for KSU from the beginning of the season. Infield drawing in here for Trey Harmon, who's in position to at least tie this game, if not better. Hilton, rough start to the season, that's putting it mildly. 4-36 on the year. Didn't have one hit last night, though. Coming in as a pinch hitter for Jacob Bullard. Also drew a walk. And the Hatter coaches have felt that Trey has had some good at-bats lately when he's made his brief appearances in games. So that's why he's getting the chance tonight. The 1-1, that's strike two. Harmon does have three RBIs on the season. He's a guy that the Hatter coaches are convinced if he can get string a couple hits together, he could get hot quickly. And that's fouled away. Harmon's a former Kentucky Wildcat. If you look at his numbers there, there's certainly reason to believe that Harmon could get hot quickly. Career average in the 270s in his time in Lexington. 1-2 from Bezdacek, and Harmon's down swinging. And now it's up to Kyle Ball with two outs here and the tying run 90 feet away. Kyle Ball seeing his first action this weekend, taking Camden Traficante's place at third base. Traficante was one of five hatters with a hit last night, and what was generally an anemic performance for Stetson, especially offensively. Coach Trimper telling me before the game that the lineup's so different tonight in large part because he wants to see some fight and a little spark out of this squad. He's hoping some benchings will get the message across. That pitch from Best to check in for the strike. Ball is making his 24th start of the season, generally been in the lineup somewhere. Lately at third, did start the year at short. That's strike two. Kyle's definitely had his struggles this year, though. His seven errors leads the team. Coming in tonight with a .225 batting average. Career-wise, though, we've certainly seen Kyle do much better. The 1-2 is high. And there's certainly every reason to believe that Kyle has the talent to perform much better than he has so far this year. He's not the only hatter who's struggled a little bit out of the gate. The 2-2, and ball is down swinging. So, outside of the leadoff triple from DePonzio, three straight punch-outs for John Bezdacek. And Kennesaw State still has the lead. Top three, 1-0. You're watching Hatter Vision. Back to the top of the lineup card for KSU. It's Josh Hatcher, the senior center fielder. Fouls off the first pitch from Durgan. Hatcher, a transfer from Mississippi State, who, of course, won the College World Series last year. And Hatcher has been KSU's offensive spark plug all season. That's a bouncer towards short. Estrella on the charge to throw to first in time. And so for the first time in this game, KSU's leadoff hitter is retired. Hatcher got a single in the first. Eventually came around to plate KSU's only run so far on the RBI single from Donovan Cash later that inning. And Tyler Simon now steps in. Simon, one of two Owls on the preseason All-A Sun team. Cash Young, the other, as time is called there. Simon, by the way, is the only Owl who has ever faced off against Stetson. You can thank COVID for that, as he swings through the fastball there. Simon, in his career, is now 15 of 35 in 8 games against Stetson. And you might be wondering why it is that he's the only KSU Owl that has actually ever faced off against Stetson. Well, COVID is the main reason for that. KSU and Stetson have not played each other in quite some time. Some of the fans not happy with that particular call from home plate ump John Bennett. And Durgan's fastball is high. Simon is 0 for 1 in this game. Popped out to the pitcher. And that one's fouled away, so the count now 2 and 2. The last time Stetson and KSU have faced off was in 2019, actually, right here in DeLand. Hatters taking 2 of 3 that weekend from KSU. Stetson winning the first two games by scores of 9-3 and 4-0. KSU ended up taking the Sunday game by a run. Stetson's had the advantage here at Melching Field in this series, although it's not much of one. 13-11 all time. Simon fouling that one away again. Overall, KSU leads the series now, 24 wins to 22 losses. All those games coming after Kennesaw State made the jump from D2 to D1 and joining the A-Sun in 2006. That's popped up foul territory. Harmon on the run. You're the first base coach's box. Makes the grab. And with two outs on the board, it's Zach Corbin who steps in. Nick Durgan with two Ks in this game. Corbin was the first victim back in the first inning. This series, all time between Stetson and KSU, has been very even for the most part. Stetson at one point won 5 games in a row against KSU. That was very early on, actually. KSU at one point won 6 in a row against Stetson. That one hit right the first, but it goes off Harmon's glove. He almost made a terrific play there to snag that one and end the inning. Corbin will reach, though. Wait on the official ruling there. It definitely hit Harmon's glove, so one could make the argument it's an error, but that will not be the case here. Score ruling it a single, so that's KSU's fourth hit of the game, and Donovan Cash will now step in. Well-hit ball there from Corbin. Definitely not an easy play for anybody at first there as the throw's over from Durgan to keep Corbin honest. Nick Durgan almost had himself his first 1-2-3 inning. 1-0 is low. Donovan Cash, he is the difference maker right now for KSU in this game. His RBI single plating Josh Hatcher from third in the first inning. And that's a bouncer towards short. Estrella's there. Flip with the glove. They get the force at second. Side retired. Heck of a play there from Andrew Estrella. And also pretty nicely done by Banks Griffith to even catch that ball and apply his foot to the bag. Bottom three coming up. Hatters trail by one. You're watching Hattervision. The last two batters in the order for the Hatters due up here. Christian Pregent, Banks Griffith. Then back up to the top with Cam Hill as Stetson trails 1-0, bottom three. John Bezdacek has so far matched his counterpart last night. Jack Myers throwing a beauty for KSU in their 11-1 victory. Myers going 7 innings, giving up only one earned run and getting 4 Ks. Bezdacek already has 4 Ks so far. Christian Pregent swinging through that one there. Count now 1-2. Bezdacek, a guy who can really rack up the Ks. His 38 is second for the team lead. Only Smith Pinson has more. Pinson, a guy who's generally been used in relief, has seen some time as a starter, though. Certainly an option to go tomorrow. KSU has not declared who will be their Sunday starter yet. Count full now on Pregent. You have to think Pinson is probably the odds-on favorite there. Although it could also be Brandon Edson. That's probably the one thing in the weekend rotation that's yet to be decided for Ryan Coe and his coaches. Is who will be that Sunday guy. Payoff one more time, and Pregent's down swinging. 4 Ks in a row for John Bezdacek. Five total. Cade Labrador to end the first, and it's been nothing but Ks ever since, outside of Nick DiPonzio's leadoff triple in the second. The third is all he would get, though. And that's the closest Stetson's gotten to tying this game. Banks Griffith getting his first start in quite a while. The former Furman Paladin lets that one go by, 1-1. Griffith was the first choice at second base for the early part of the season. Swings through that one. Make the count now 1-2. Griffith ran into some issues defensively on the field and also a somewhat cold bat, and it opened the door for guys like Estrella and Traficante. And Griffith is down swinging.
Return to the top of the order for the center fielder, Cameron.
So give Bezdacek 5 Ks in a row now as we go back to the top in Cam Hill. Bezdacek already close to a single game high in strikeouts. He had 9 in his second start of the year. That one coming against Fairfield, a game that KSU would eventually win. He's also had 2 games of 7 strikeouts. Morehead State to open the year. Troy in his third start of the year. All 3 of those KSU wins, as it turns out. That's popped up and out of play. Cam Hill is 0-for-1, popped out to short in the first inning. Really more to shallow center, but it was Tyler Simon who made the play. The 1-2 is popped up again and out of play. Bezdacek is a guy who hasn't gone very deep in the games, though. It's only twice all season where he's gone to 6 innings. Has 2 other games where he went to 5. All those coming early in the season, relatively. His last 2 starts, not been particularly great. The 2-2, and Hill fouls that off again. Cam Hill giving Bezdacek a battle here. like he did in the first inning, actually. Hill forcing Bezdacek to throw 8 pitches before he was finally retired. And now we're looking at a full count. Here's the payoff. And that's ball 4. So Bezdacek gives up his first walk. Bezdacek with 11 walks on the season, which is tied for second on the team, actually, with Jack Myers. But certainly a guy with a fairly decent walk to K ratio, 38 to 11, now 12. Well, actually, the 38 does not include the 6 strikeouts so far, so 44 Ks to 12 walks now. Gets ahead here on Hilton, who is 0 for 1 in this game, grounded out the third, and is only at bat so far. KSU not employing too extreme of a shift this time against Hilton. There was times Friday night where you saw Hilton basically facing off against 3 infielders all to the right side of the second base bag. Hilton was 0 for 4 last night. And moving up one spot in the order, he batted third as the DH last night, now batting second and playing in right. Runner going, the throw is high to throw down the second, and Cam Hill swipes his 16th bag of the season. That's the check with the fastball there, but way high for Nick Hassan, and that gave Cam Hill all he needed. Cam doesn't need much to steal a bag. We're in a scoring position here. Hill's going, and Hilton's down swinging. So 7 punch-outs now for John Bezdacek through 3 innings. We head to the top of the fourth with KSU holding the 1-0 lead. You're watching Hattervision.
Yo.
5, 6, and 7 here for KSU. Blasted Stetson out of the ballpark last night, winning by 10 runs. And as of right now, in the driver's seat to take the weekend series, if they can hold on to the lead tonight. Cash Young is 0 for 1 in this one. Popped out to right field in the first inning. He had himself a day yesterday, though. 2 home runs. He now leads KSU in homers with 7. Both of his shots pull jobs to left field and absolute no doubters. The second one in particular smashed it right over the scoreboard here at Melching. And you got to hit the ball pretty well here to get it out there, even with a little assistance from the wind. 1-2 count now. And Cash Young's down swinging. Nick Durgin with his third punch out. And with 1 out on the board, it's now Hudson Mims who will step in.
Hudson Mims.
KSU with four hits in this game. Mims with one of them, a single. All four of KSU's hits have been singles so far. One of them from Donovan Cash, the lone RBI single, and the difference in this game. We are keeping an eye on you, for you, on other results in the conference tonight. Some interesting finals in already. There's actually only one game in progress right now in the A-Sun. Top seven over on the west side, where Central Arkansas and Jacksonville State are doing battle. In the natural state, it's UCA with the 11-8 lead over JSU, top seven. That's a battle of the number two and number three teams right now in the A-Sun West. The 2-2 is hit. Oppo in the right field. It'll bounce right in front of Brandon Hilton. So Hudson Mims gets himself his second single of the night on that 2-2 shot. And that'll bring up the DH, Spencer Hansen.
Now batting designated hitter, Spencer Hansen.
The other two games in the A-Sun East have gone final. UNF getting the series win this weekend in the River City Rumble, 5-3 winners over Jacksonville. Liberty with a chance to sweep Gulf Coast, the Flames getting the 8-3 win over the Eagles tonight. Hansen swings through that fastball. And that's music to the ears of KSU fans, because Gulf Coast and KSU were tied for the top of the East standings entering the weekend. KSU now in sole possession of first, and with a chance to extend that lead over Gulf Coast to 2 if they can come through with a win tonight over Stetson. I don't believe Gulf Coast has been swept all year. They're at risk of doing that unless they get the win tomorrow against the Flames. The 2-1 runner going. That's a pop-up in the foul territory, first base side. Harmon makes the grab, pitches the first, double play as Mims was on the run. And that is all it does for Kennesaw State there. Nick Durgan facing the minimum, albeit unconventionally. Bottom of the fourth coming up. Stetson trails by one. You're watching Hattervision. Daniel Labrador will step in here for Stetson. 3-4-5 for a Hatter squad that is looking to dent the scoreboard for the first time tonight. It's been a rough series for Stetson offensively so far anyway. Labrador's 0-for-1. He K'd to end the first inning. Bezdacek has been ringing him up tonight. 7 so far, and Labrador now facing an 0-2 count. The lefty fires, and Labrador is again down on 3 straight pitches for the second at-bat in a row. 8 punch-outs for Bezdacek, and with one out of the board, it's the one-hatter with a hit who comes up. Nick DiPonzio led off the second with a triple. A bloop shot down the left field line that dug itself into the track in foul territory. Zach Corbin had trouble corralling it. Probably would have been a double if Corbin had corralled it cleanly, but DiPonzio was able to take advantage and move up another 90 feet. Ultimately, though, Stetson not able to cash in. DiPonzio stranded at third as Estrella, Harmon, and Ball all struck out to end the inning. Bezdacek gets the strike call there, 1-1. Bezdacek with his 8 Ks, he's now one away from his season high. Had 9 against Fairfield in his second start of the year. And DiPonzio swings through the high cheese there to make it 1-2. Bezdacek has looked quite comfortable so far in this game. 1-2, and he misses outside there. Stetson managing only one run on 5 hits and 2 errors last night. And DiPonzio's down looking. That's the first K looking for John Bezdacek as he ties a season high in Ks. And with DiPonzio going down, Bezdacek has struck out every hatter in the starting 9 tonight with the exception of Cam Hill. First pitch, Estrella popped up. Foul territory on the third base side. And it's Cash Young who snags it. So 1-2-3 go the hatters here in the bottom of the fourth. Top 5 coming up. Kennesaw State 1, Stetson nothing. You're watching Hatter Vision.
Hassan.
8-9-1 for KSU as we begin the top of the fifth. Nick Hassan, Nick Kalina, Josh Hatcher. And the first pitch of Hassan plunks him.
Now batting right fielder, Nick Kalina.
And that is the first hit by pitch given up by Stetson so far in this game. Third time so far in this game that the Owls have managed to get their leadoff batter on. Kalina squares the bunt. Durgan gets the strike on the outside there. Kalina 0-for-1, like Hassan, pop out the center field in the second inning. And Kalina drops the bunt right in front of the mound. He only plays the first. And that's where Durgan goes. So the sack bunt does its job. Hassan moves up the second. And now it brings up the dangerous Josh Hatcher, senior center fielder who has just been a machine for KSU this season offensively. Entering the night batting 397, former Mississippi State Bulldog has had some very, very strong offensive performances in games. He's hit two grand slams this year. And that's popped up in the left field. DeBonzio backing up. Snags it right in front of the Insight Credit Union banner. And Hassan not able to move up on the throw in. So with two outs on the board here, it's Tyler Simon who steps in. And just so you know on Hatcher, one of those grand slams, of course, came last night. Hatcher's also hit for the cycle twice this year, which is a first in KSU history. No other KSU Owl has ever hit for the cycle, at least in their time in D1. And Hatcher managed to do it twice this year against Georgia Tech and UNF. First pitch, and that's popped up. Foul territory, Harmon on the run. He won't have a play, though. That'll actually go into the stands. And eventually come to a stop on the roof of the Stetson dugout. The 0-1, and that smacked opposite field foul. KSU being very aggressive early here against Durgan. Simon is 0-for-2 in this game, pop-outs both times to the pitcher in the first inning, which was nearly a double-up, and then popped out in foul territory, first base side in the third inning. That was his last at bat. And that one is fouled off. Hit the dirt after it hit off the end of Simon's bat. Simon, a senior from Albany, Georgia. Of course, Kennesaw State based in Georgia. The vast majority of their roster is from the Peach State, 35 out of 40. The 0-2, and Simon lays off. And KSU is going to be playing a lot of games in Georgia before this season ends, and I don't just mean at home. They're out of conference schedule filled with in-state rivals. The 1-2 is popped up and out of play. Taking a look at KSU out of conference, they got two games against the Georgia Bulldogs. That'll actually be their midweek game later this week, after this series comes to an end. The KSU will be hosting the Bulldogs at home and then returning the trip in May. KSU also has a date against Auburn later this month. Did that hit Simon? I think it did. That's what Simon's arguing. John Bennett says, no, sir. Not hearing it. And Ryan Coe, the head coach for KSU, he wants to have a word with Mr. Bennett. Simon clearly arguing that he was hit by the ball. Hard for us to tell from our angle. We're going to see a consultation here. Shannon Jernigan and Marcial Santos will come in to lend their thoughts. I'm inclined to believe Simon here. I think he was hit. Normally, when the ball goes off the bat, you hear something We didn't hear anything. I didn't hear anything anyway through the field mic. And normally when that's the case, that means that a player got hit. But I don't know if that's enough to overturn it necessarily, and doesn't look like that will be the case here. The call will stand on the field, so Simon is going to have to see at least one more pitch here. 1-2 count. Nick Durgan looking to put up another zero. And that's a high chopper foul down the third baseline. KSU, a team with a very high RPI entering this weekend. Number 14 in the country, as a matter of fact. Far and away the leader in the A-Sun. A 1-2. And that's a swing and a miss for strike three, but Pregent has to throw to first to complete the strikeout. And he does. So Durgan with four punch-outs through five innings. Hatters will grab the bats here in the bottom of the fifth. When we come back, you're watching Hatter Vision. Trey Harmon will lead us off here for Stetson in the bottom of the fifth. Hatters have faced a buzzsaw so far in John Bezdacek. His 9 Ks already tying a season high. Harmon was struck out in the second and is only at bat so far. Harmon now facing a 2-0 count. A 2-0, and Harmon swings through that one. Trey, as you may have guessed, that's not his first name. Full name, French Baker Harmon III. So that's where the Trey comes from. The 2-1 misses low. Harmon, 6'4", 235 from Somerset, Kentucky. Going for his MBA here at Stetson. After spending most of his collegiate career wearing the blue and white of the Kentucky Wildcats. And Harmon draws the walk. And that is the second time all game that Stetson's gotten the leadoff runner on. Well, the leadoff batter, I should say. Take your pick, I guess. The Ponzio's triple in the second, the only other time we've seen it. Kyle Ball steps in now. He's also 0 for 1 with a K. Besta checked, by the way. Now at over 70 pitches in this contest. Besta check on average has been around the 80 to 90 mark. And we're going to see a pinch runner here for Harmon. Connor Keel stepping in. And that'll certainly make things a little interesting. As Kyle Ball steps in with Keel on there. Keel, of course, much more fleet of foot than Harmon. Throw over the first. Keel has not stolen any bases this year, but certainly capable of it. He is one of the faster guys on this Hatters roster. Another throw over to first, and that got away from Donovan Cash. Keel will take advantage. He moves up 90 feet. And that will certainly be a throwing error on the Owls on Bezdacek. And for the third time in this game, Stetson's got a runner in scoring position. Hatters weren't able to cash in the first two times. Ball trying to square to throw to second to get Keel back there. Steve Trimper electing to go to the bench early here. Try to get his team back into this one. Certainly worked from that perspective. Ball trying to bunt. It's a popper, and Nick Hassan not able to get to it. That ball ran in on Kyle's hands. Very awkward bunt attempt there from the graduate. Yeah, the infield charging all the way too. The corners anyway, Cash Young and Donovan Cash at third and first respectively. Looks like KSU's fine with conceding Keel to third. If there's another bunt attempt, there's not. As ball swings away, and that's popped up and out of play. So the count now 1-2. Hatters have only scored one run so far in this weekend series. That one coming in the seventh inning of last night's game after Kennesaw State had put up 9. The 1-2. And a ball hits that between short and third. Keel will hold at third. Trimper giving him the sign to stay. And with runners at the corners, it's now up to Christian Pregent. Kyle gets his first single of this game. Christian Pregent, if he does likewise, it'll be at least a tied game. More than likely. Pregent's 0 for 1 with a K. Pregent has struggled at the plate this year, making his 18th start. Only 8 hits and 50 at bats. 51, actually, if you count the K in the second inning. Bezicek fires that in for the strike. Pregent does have a home run, though. It came in Stetson's last win here at Melching Field. Against UNF, a 2-run shot that hugged the left field line. Cole Stallings made it hold up for the complete game 7-inning shutout. The 0-1, and that's hit hard in the left field, but it'll go out of play. And that's one thing about Christian. He's got a lot of power in that bat. He might be one of the stronger hitters in that sense in the lineup. The issue with him has been getting contact more often than not, but if he barrels one up, it's usually very hard hit. The 0-2. Runner going to throw down the second. They got ball and a rundown. Keel will come in to score, though. And ball, does he give himself up? He does. I think he was out of the baseline, so out regardless, but The aggressive base running cost the Hatters an out, but it does give them a run. So Christian Pregent doesn't have to worry about driving anyone in now on this 1-2 count. And the fastball from Bezdacek misses high. And Bezdacek, he wanted that 10th K of the night. He's going to need at least one more pitch, though. Bezdacek looking in his right arm on the inside for the sign. Here's your payoff. And Pregent hits that hard in the left field. Stetson's got the lead. Solo bomb from the catcher. It's 2-1 Hatters. Well, as it turns out, they didn't need all that monkeying around on the bases to get the lead. It would have been a three-run shot otherwise, but Hatter Nation won't complain. First time all weekend that they're in front against Kennesaw. Full count blast there. Much like his shot in the UNF game. Hugging that left field line. Christian's very much a puller. You saw it right there. And KSU is going to have a consultation on the mound. Matthew Passauer, the pitching coach out there. The only member of this KSU coaching staff, actually, who isn't a former Owl player. Ryan Coe very much dipping into the Owl alumni ranks to fill his coaching positions. Coe himself a former KSU player back in their D2 days. Derek Tucker, their hitting coach, also a former KSU player. Their volunteer assistant, Austin Upshaw also. Bo Way, their student assistant, also a former KSU player. So Banks Griffith will step up here with one out on the board. And really, for the first time all weekend, you can see the Hatter faithful energized. The Saturday night crowd here at Melching, definitely a little bigger than we saw last night. Of course, some of that due to the promotion for the day. Stetson honoring all their student employees. Students very much an integral part of making things work, especially in athletics. Many times here on Hatter Vision, we use students and student athletes primarily to help us do a lot of the behind the scenes stuff. So definitely vital to the work that we do. Count now 1-2 for Banks Griffith after he fouls that pitch off. He's 0-1 with a K. And Bezdacek fires high and outside. Count now 2-2. Bezdacek, by the way, now has thrown over 80 pitches. But for the first time all game, has really run into trouble here against Stetson. And Griffith is going to face a full count pitch here. Tomorrow will be another promotion day for Stetson here at Melching Youth Day. And that's fouled up and out of play. Kiddo's getting in free. That one, was it caught in the stands? I think it was. Nicely done there, man. Somebody in section 205, I think. Griffith hits that hard in the center. Hatcher's there, dives and makes the grab. So Griffith retired for the second time. And Cycle back to the top here in Cam Hill. Cam Hill still looking for his first hit, but did extend his on-base streak to 25 games now with his walk in the third. Swiped the bag as well for his team-leading 16th. First pitch is a bleeder towards second. Mims there to make the play, side retired, but John Bezdacek ran into trouble for the first time all game, and it cost them the lead. Trey Harmon with a walk gave way to Connor Keel, who eventually made his way around the bags coming in to score when Kyle Ball got caught stealing from first to second. And then Christian Prejean's solo bomb is the difference right now. Top six coming up on Hatter Vision. Defensive change for the Hatters here, as we were expecting with Trey Harmon being lifted for a pinch runner. It'll be Jacob Bullard who comes in to play first base. So Connor Keel's night also coming to an end. Nick Durgan for the first time is working with a lead. 2-1, Stetson up over KSU. And KSU in an unfamiliar spot for them this weekend. They led pretty much wire to wire last night. Corbin swings through the breaking pitch there, 0-2. And Nick Durgan making his first Saturday start of the season. Has generally been Stetson's Friday night guy when healthy. Fires fastball high there, 1-2. Speaking with Coach Trimper before the game, he mentioned that they made the move to have Durgan pitch Saturday instead of Friday because they wanted to get Danny Garcia in the starting rotation. Garcia, prior to last night, had pitched very well for Stetson. Hadn't even given up a walk until last night, but of course, KSU tattooed him pretty good. Whether that remains the plan moving forward, we'll see, but I wouldn't be surprised if they keep Garcia in the starting rotation. That KSU game really is only hiccup this season. And that's hit hard in the center on the run as Hill. He trapped it. Acted like he caught the ball. Cam Hill looking for the Oscar-winning performance right there, but Marcial Santos at first base wasn't having it. So Corbin leads off a single here for Kennesaw State.
First baseman, Donovan Cash.
And that is the third time in this game that KSU's led off with a single. The fourth they've led off with the leadoff runner on board. The only one that wasn't a hit was Hassan last inning when he was plunked. And now Donovan Cash steps in. He's reached both times that he's been at the plate. Fielder's choice in the third. Singled in the first, and that one drove in Josh Hatcher. That's KSU's only run so far. Sophomore first baseman looking at a 1-1 count here from Durgan. And a battle of sophomores here. And Stetson, sophomore, fires in the strike. Donovan Cash, he wears number 25. 5'11", 200-pounder from Sharpsburg, Georgia. That one hit in the left field. The Ponzio won't have to go too far back, though. Snags it for out number one.
Third baseman, Cash Young.
And that brings up Cash Young. He's been quiet tonight. 0-for-2 so far. Pop out to right field in the first. Cade in the fourth. But if you watch last night's game, you know what he's capable of. Two home runs in that contest. He leads KSU with 7 on the season. Also close to the team lead in RBIs. He's only 2 away from Josh Hatcher. Hatcher with 27. Cash Young with 25. Young is the only graduate, one of 2 graduate players on this roster. The only one in the starting lineup tonight, though. The other graduate is Mason Jones, who's one of the catchers. We've not seen him this weekend. Oh, 1, and Young swings through that one. Hatter pen filled with a whole bunch of pitchers right now. No one really warming up, though, as Durgan has gotten more comfortable as this game's gone along. That one's chopped foul down the third baseline. Durgan right now nearing 80 pitches. He's probably just over it, actually. Nick's had some rough outings in his return to the lineup. Missed the first month or so of the season due to shoulder issues. The 0-2, and that's fouled away by Cash Young. Durgan, of course, a guy that Stetson was relying on to be that workhorse in the early part of the weekend. The other guy that they were hoping would take that role could be back very soon in Daniel Perrett. He's probably a week or two away from potentially returning. He's also dealing with arm issues. Perrett has missed a lot of time because of those arm issues, but having said that, wasn't all that long ago when Danny Perrett had a terrific freshman season. Lefty certainly very capable. The 0-2, runner going. That's popped up. In the right field, Brandon Hilton drifting towards it, makes the grab. Can of corn there for the big man. And with 2 out down, with 2 now down, it's Hudson Mims who steps in. Dave Thurno, Stetson's pitching coach, is coming out. This won't be a call to the pen. There's no one warming up for Stetson. At least no one I saw. Although we might see some steering up pretty soon. Nick Durgan this year hasn't gone very deep in the games, but something that we all expected considering he was coming back from shoulder issues. Coach is trying to work him in slowly. His longest outing so far this year was his last start against North Florida, where he went 6 innings. A game that Stetson eventually won 5-3. That was actually the first time all year that Durgan got past 4 innings in a game. Until tonight, of course. Mims' first pitch is fouled away. Stetson looking to knot the weekend series at 1 with a victory tonight. Forcing a winner-take-all, if you will, tomorrow here at Melching. 1 o'clock expected start. We'll have it for you, of course, on Hatter Vision as that's popped up in the right field. Banks Griffith drifting back, but he'll give way to Brandon Hilton. Side retired. So Nick Durgan puts up another 0, his 5th in a row. And the Hatters will try to extend their 2-1 lead. Bottom 6 coming up on Hatter Vision. 2, 3, and 4 here for the team in the green tops and white pants. Brandon Hilton, Daniel Labrador, Nick DiPonzio. Our thanks for you to join us on Hatter Vision this Saturday evening, a cool one here at Melching Field. New pitcher in the game for KSU, Smith Pinson, coming in relief of John Bezdacek, who had himself a pretty stellar outing. That is, until the bottom of the fifth came along. Pinson with two breakers there. That last one a ball. 1-1 the count now on the big man, Brandon Hilton, who's 0-2 tonight. KSU employing that shift on him again. 1-1, Hilton backs away, and actually they're going to say he went around on the check swing, so 1-2. A lot of opponents this year against Stetson have employed this shift on Hilton. He is a guy who pulls the ball a lot, but he can go opposite field. Check swing there, appeal to third, and he's down swinging. They throw to first to complete the strikeout just to make sure. And Brandon Hilton down by K for the second time this evening. So the rest of the infield will come into their normal position. And Labrador is coming out of this game. Steve Trimper electing to go to the bench. And it's the freshman Juan Correa who steps in. Correa, of course, got the start for the Hatters last night in right field, 1-for-4. Correa's kind of bounced around in the lineup between right field and DH. Coaches have wanted to get his bat in somehow, some way. He's certainly been very good at the plate for the most part this year for Stetson. Listed initially as an infielder to begin the season, but he's yet to see any time in the infield. It's been in right field when he's played defense at all. That's a bouncer. Slow one towards third. Charging is Cash Young to throw to first in time. And Donovan Cash with a nice snag there, actually. Correa is down, and that's two outs now for Nick DiPonzio. Nick DiPonzio with one of Stetson's three hits tonight. The only extra base one besides Preget's solo bomb, a triple in the second. He was eventually stranded at third, though. DiPonzio showing bunt with two outs on the board. As someone might say, bold strategy there. That one is a bleeder again to the mound. Pinson's there, and he sends the Hatters down. 1-2-3. So we're through six here at Melching. Stetson with the slimmest of margins as we begin the top of the seventh. After this on Hatter Vision. bottom of the lineup card here for Ryan Coe. Spencer Hansen, Nick Hassan, Nick Kalina all due up, but looks like Hansen's night is done. Braden Edson will step in here to take some swings. Edson is one of three two-way players on this KSU roster. Has seen time as a pitcher and also as a hitter. Also seen time in the outfield and in the infield. That one is hit oppo field. On the run is DiPonzio. Long one for him, but he makes the grab. So two pitches is all it took to retire Edson. And that brings up Nick Hassan. Hassan looking the bunt there. Let's it go. And that misses. Hassan has only reached once this evening. That was on a hit by pitch in the fifth. Popped out the center and his only other at bat in the second. The 1-1 is hit sharply towards second on the ground, but picked up cleanly by Banks Griffith. And that's two outs.
And the right fielder, Nick Kalina.
And now Nick Kalina will step in here. Nick Durgan. Already with a season high in innings pitched at 6 2/3. Nearing 100 pitches in this game. He's already over 90. We're seeing some action in the pen. I don't think we're going to see Durgan much longer. And that misses. One ball and a strike. We've got a righty and a lefty going for the Hatters. Austin Amaral warming up. He's the righty. And the lefty is Nick Ciceri. The 2-1 misses. Count now 3-1. So it looks like Stetson wants to go double barrel in the pen to see what the matchup is, if they want to move on from Durgan, and that is Durgan's first free pass of the game. Kalina drawing the two-out walk, bringing up the dangerous Josh Hatcher. This guy has had some crazy games this year. Has twice hit for the cycle. Has hit two grand slams in different games. Had one game where he hit four doubles. And that's up and out of play. Hatcher went 2-for-6 last night with the four RBIs, all of them coming, of course, off the grand slam in the second inning. Pops that one out of play over the third base stance. Count is 0-2. Hatcher has actually hit in 24 consecutive games. That includes his single in the first inning tonight. The 0-2. And Hatcher backing off. Hatcher coming to KSU this year with some championship pedigree. He was a member of the Mississippi State Bulldog squad that took the College World Series last year. The 1-2, runner going, and the hit and run works to perfection. That stays fair. Derek Tucker not hesitating. He's sending Kalina home. The throw is cut off, and we are tied. Josh Hatcher with an RBI double has knotted this one at 2. We saw KSU do their damage with the long ball last night. That time, showing they can manufacture when needed. The hit and run is what allowed Colino to score. Otherwise, he's probably at third, even though Hilton had to go a long way to dig that ball out of the right field corner. First pitch by Simon, to Simon, I should say, is hitting the center, and Cam Hill's there to make the grab. So Simon is retired, but Nick Durgin gives up another run to tie this game at two. Bleacher Creatures will lead us in the stretch here. Bottom of the seventh coming up on Hatter Vision. Five, six, and seven for the Hatters as they enter new territory for them, if you will, this weekend. We are tied at two between KSU and Stetson. Owls looking to secure the weekend series with a victory tonight. Stetson looking to force the winner take all tomorrow. Been an interesting weekend of results in the A-Sun so far. All of the games today in the Atlantic Sun have gone final except for this one. Central Arkansas, 11-9 winners over Jacksonville State out in the West. And Estrella swings through that one to make it 2-1. JSU got the win on Friday night, so that'll be a winner-take-all tomorrow. All the other series could be potential sweeps. Liberty 8-3 winners over Gulf Coast. The Flames, who were tied with Stetson entering the weekend for third in the A-Sun East, have now improved their conference record to over 500 with the win over Gulf Coast. And Estrella now looking at a full count here against Smith Pinson. Golf course, of course, was tied with Kennesaw State for the top in the East entering the weekend. KSU now in sole possession of first. And Estrella down swinging. So second punch out for Smith Pinson in this one. And now Jacob Bullard will step in for his first at bat of the evening. Bullard, of course, Stetson's normal starting first baseman. One of several who found himself on the bench tonight. In his case, in favor of Trey Harmon. Harmon drawing a walk in the fifth and was lifted for a pinch runner. Connor Keel would eventually come around to score Stetson's first run of the game. And shortly after he did, Christian Pregent's solo bomb gave Stetson a brief lead. Bullard goes oppo field. But Nick Kalina's on the run. He makes the grab.
Third baseman, Kyle Ball.
So two pitches is all it took to retire Bullard. And now Kyle Ball will step in. Who, in many ways, was responsible for Stetson's first run in this game, albeit a bit unconventionally. Singled in the fifth, which put runners at the corners. Keel was at second at the time after he reached on a throwing error from Bezdacek. And then Kyle broke from first toward second on a pitch to the plate. Owls would eventually run him down, 2-4-3 on the caught stealing, but Keel would come in to score from third on the play to give Stetson their first run. Ball one of four captains on this Hatters roster. Hits that one on the ground towards short. Scooped up by Simon. The throw to first is in time, and the side is retired. So another 1-2-3 inning for Smith Pinson. He's retired six in a row. Top eight coming up. We're not at it, too. You're watching Hattervision.
Is the left fielder Zach Corbin.
It's not very often you hear flight of the bumblebee at a baseball game, right? Well, at Stetson, it means that Nick Ciceri's coming in. So, Nick Durgin's night is done. Final line on Durgin. Seven innings pitched on 99 pitches thrown. Seven hits, two runs, one earned, one walk, four Ks. 29 batters faced, and he will get the no decision. And what was his best start of the year. So now Nick Ciceri making his fifth appearance of the season. The veteran lefty entering with a 1-0 record and a 10.80 ERA. Fires outside, and that misses 2-0 to Zach Corbin. Still got a righty warming in the pen for Stetson. Austin Amaral, I believe. Yep, it is Amaral. The 2-0, and Ciceri gets the strike. Last time we saw Nick was the only time he's pitched in a conference game this year against Florida Gulf Coast. Roughest outing of the year by far. Did not record an out. Gave up four runs, all earned. 2-1, misses low. Cesari's appearance coming in that game where Gulf Coast put up 25 runs, the most Stetson has ever allowed in a home game in their history. The 3-1. And Corbin reaches on a walk. And now Jonathan Cash will step up to the plate, and we're going to see a conference on the mound here. Dave Thurno, who's not wasting any time. He's going to the pen. So that's it for Nick Cesari. Austin Amaral will step in when we come back. Top eight. We're knotted at two here at Melching. You're watching Hatter Vision. Nick Cesari out, Austin Amaral in. The sophomore righty will toe the slab here for Stetson. With no outs in the top of the eighth and one on. First pitch is hit in the right field. That's over Hilton's head and off the wall. Runners moving up, and Zach Corbin will stay at third. On the first pitch double, Donovan Cash with his second hit of the game. And one pitch, was all it took to make the fire a lot hotter here for Austin Amaral as he faces Cash Young. Amaral, the sophomore from DeBerry, 1-1 record with a 3.54 ERA. Last time we saw him, it was in the midweek game against Florida State. That fastball goes all the way to the padding and the backstop, but as you can see, Austin Amaral throws pretty quick and very fast, and so that actually helped in that case, because had it been any slower, you probably see Zach Corbin sprinting home from third and KSU's got the lead. Amaral with a fastball that can definitely hit mid-90s. That one outside, and the count now 2-0 on Cash Young, who's 0-3 tonight. But plenty dangerous, as we saw last night. Two homers in that game. He leads KSU at 7. And with runners at second and third, KSU in position to get the lead back, as Austin's fastball is high. Amaral yet to find a strike here. We do have more action in the pen for Stetson. As Nick Durbin, and what was probably his best starter outing of the season, he'll get the no decision. The question is, can Stetson get the win as Amaral gets the strike? That's Rashesh Pandya warming up in the pen for Stetson. We also saw him last against Florida State. He actually ended up taking the L for the Hatters in that one. The 3-1 is fouled away sharply, too. Amaral with some real gas. He's had kind of an up-and-down season. He's had some brilliant performances. There's also been times where he's been hit. Stetson hoping for the brilliance here. They're going to need it. Here's your payoff. And that's ball four. And that brings up Hudson Mims. So bases loaded for KSU here and nobody out. Austin Amaral is going to really have to pull a rabbit out of the hat here. If he's going to hold KSU to no runs. Mims with two singles on the night. First pitch swinging. Can't catch up to the heat. We saw something similar in the Florida State game. Chris Gonzalez coming in, bases loaded, none out. And he managed to hold the Seminoles to no runs. The 0-1, and KSU's got the lead. Single opposite field will play at least one. The throw to home is cut off by the catcher, and that could have been a rundown situation for KSU. Fortunate for them, it wasn't. They got the lead, though. Corbin coming in the score. It's 3-2 KSU. Mims with his third single of the game, and the first one that's an RBI.
Number 21, Braden Edison.
Braden Edison will step in here, making his second at bat of the game, coming in as a pinch hitter in the seventh. He popped out to left field. The seventh spot in the order for KSU, yet to get a hit or even reach, actually. Amaral's first pitch in for the strike. So the Hatters, if they want to win this game, they're going to have to find some late inning magic. The question is, how much are they going to need? That one hit right to Bullard. He'll throw to home for the force. The throw to first, not in time, according to the first base ump. That would have been a big double play. And Steve Tripper's coming out to argue it. Just so you know, there is no replay in games where ESPN does not broadcast. Since there is no ESPN broadcast tonight, there is no video monitor for them to look at. So the only way this call is getting overturned is if there's a conference, which is probably what Steve Tripper is looking for. He's having a chat with Marcial Santos. Tripper's not happy about it. He thought that Edson was out on the play. Or there will not be a meeting of the minds for the men in blue. But Stetson at least prevents the lead run from scoring. So with one out on the board here, it's Nick Hassan, the catcher, who steps in. First pitch swinging for him is fouled out of play. So now you've got Cash Young sitting at third, Hudson Mims at second, Braden Edson at first as he reached on the fielder's choice. The 0-1 is fouled off, right into the dirt, actually. Nothing in two now for Nick Hassan, the sophomore from Fayetteville, Georgia. He's only reached once this evening. That was on a hit-by-pitch in the fifth. KSU's already plated one here in this top of the eighth. The 0-2 is hit hard in the left field. Will that stay fair? It will not. But not by much. couple of feet at most. Probably less, being honest. Fortunate break there for Stetson. That would have been a potential basis clearer for KSU. 0-2 count now for Hassan. Austin Amaral thrust once again into a big spot in the late innings. He's a guy who can go in long relief, but Stetson does like him as a late innings guy, potentially, as that's fouled away past Derek Tucker in the third base coach's box. You can see why with that fastball. He's got one of the fastest fastballs on the Stetson team. Kind of a toss-up between him and Tanner Martin. Nick Durgin, when he's fully healthy, might be able to get up there. The 0-2, and that's hit towards second, gathered up by Estrella. He steps on the bag for one, and that's a double play! So the run won't count. And we got a run down, actually, at third, and another tag out. That double play should have ended the inning. Steve Tripper coming out to argue this one. I'm not sure what the confusion is. That was a double play. That tag out at third should not have mattered. But it does matter because if there's no double play, then the run will score. So we got to sort this out. This could potentially be a big call here. And the umps, are they going to talk about this? I don't think there's much to talk about. That looked like a clear double play to me. We'll try to sort it out when we get back. Regardless, the inning is over, and they are going to rule it a double play. So that's what the call is. There will only be one run scored in that inning. Hatters trail 3-2, bottom eight, coming up on Hatter Vision. So he who had the only homer in this game so far will lead us off here in this bottom of the eighth. Christian Pregent, Banks Griffith, Cam Hill do up behind him as the Hatters trail by one. 3-2. Bottom eight. Thanks for joining us on Hatter Vision. I'm Asad Bendian, Charlie Franklin, keeping the lens clean and focused for you. And what has turned into a very tight and dramatic affair here in Melching. First pitch, the Pregent in for the strike. Pregent with only one hit in this game, but it was a monster. solo bomb in the fifth that gave Stetson the lead. Pinson firing. Count now 1-1. Smith Pinson working his third inning here, and he's been golden so far for KSU. Two straight 1-2-3 innings. The 1-1 hit sharply to third, snagged by Cash Young, and the throw across the diamond in time. Cash Young was hugging that line tight. And fortunate for KSU that it was, because otherwise that would have been a double easily. And we're going to see a pinch hitter here for Banks Griffith. Johan Desereau is coming in. Desereau, one of two switch hitters on this Hatters roster. Camden Traficante, the other. Desereau getting the night off at second. In large part because of who KSU had on the mound, Hatter coaches didn't want Johan to face a lefty. He has struggled against Southpaws this year. But Pinson, of course, is a righty, so that doesn't apply here. Desereau among the team leaders in homers. He has three. Him and Brandon Hilton tied in that particular sense. Desereau, one of two Canadians on this Hatters roster. He's the only one who's played this year, though. And that was quick. Desereau down swinging. And with two outs on the board, top of the order here for Stetson, Cam Hill will step in. Three pitches was all it took to get Desereau down by K. That is the third K for Smith Pinson so far. And the off-speed from Pinson's in for the strike. Pinson is somebody that was potentially being considered for a Sunday start. Probably off the board now that he's come in relief. But right now he's in line for the win as Cam Hill is down 0-2 here. Pinson, among the team leaders in ERA, 3.06 entering the night. And Hill's down swinging. So Desereau and Cam Hill both down on three straight pitches. And we head into the ninth with KSU looking to extend their lead before taking Stetson down in the bottom of the ninth. KSU 3, Stetson 2. Top 9 coming up on Hatter Vision.
For your headers, remaining in the game to play second base, number 38, Johan Desereau. And leading off the top of the ninth,
Nick Kalina, Josh Hatcher, Tyler Simon due up here for the black and gold as that goes bouncing off the edge of the roof that covers the grandstand area here. And that's how we begin this top of the ninth. Austin Amaral still on the bump for Stetson. Fastball is fouled away by Kalina. who has reached only once tonight on a walk in the seventh. Kalina, one of two lefties in the batting lineup for Ryan Coe. That doesn't count Zach Corbin, who's a switch hitter. Braden Edson, also a lefty bat, came in as a pinch hitter. The 1-2, and Kalina's down swinging. So Austin Amaral gets his first K. Stetson with just five Ks on the night. Four of those coming from Durgan, of course. Josh Hatcher will step in. He's got two hits on the evening. Single in the first, came around to score. RBI double in the seventh. That RBI double in the seventh tied this game at two. Hatcher entering this weekend batting over 400. Batting at 400, actually. It's probably over it now, though. Swings right through that fastball for strike two. Hatcher leads KSU in most of their offensive categories. Homers, doubles, triples, RBIs, total bases, slugging, batting average, at-bats. And he'll improve with that hot shot up the middle. Third hit of the game.
The shortstop.
Tyler Simon will come in now. It's been a quiet night for Simon. He's 0 for 4. Two pop-outs, a strikeout, a line-out. First pitch hit hard towards short. The second for one. The turn. Double play.
That's it for the top of the ninth inning.
And the Hatters are out of it. Austin Amaral only needed to face three, getting the pitcher's best friend. But right now, Stetson needs some runs. Bottom of the ninth, coming up. Hatters down by one. You're watching Hatter Vision.
Bottom of the ninth inning, right fielder, Brandon Hilton.
If you like some drama with your baseball, here you go. Bottom of the ninth, KSU 3, Stetson 2. A win for the Owls gives them the weekend series and a chance at a sweep manana. Stetson wants to force the winner take all. They're going to need at least one run here. As Brandon Hilton swings right through the breaking pitch from Smith Pinson, 0-1. Smith Pinson has retired all nine Stetson Hatters he's faced so far in this game. He's had three 1-2-3 innings in a row. Hilton gets the end of that breaking pitch, and he's down quickly 0-2. Been a rough night for Brandon, 0 for 3. Grounded out to third in the first inning. K's in the third and in the sixth. And as you can see, KSU employing that shift on him again. The 0-2. And that one is a slow bouncer towards second, but it's gathered up by Tyler Simon, the shortstop. And the throw to first is in time. So technically a ground out to short, even though the ball went to the right side of the infield. And with two outs left for Stetson, it's Juan Correa who steps up now. Nick DiPonzio on deck. Hatters have not gotten a runner on board since the fifth inning. As a matter of fact, the last time that Stetson had a batter do anything other than record an out was Pregent's solo homer in the fifth. So 12 consecutive retired here by KSU pitching from that point on. The 0-1, and Correa swings right through the breaker. Smith Pinson has been dialed in. The freshman from Leesburg, Georgia. Swings through that one, does Correa for strike three. They got to throw to first to complete the strikeout, but they don't. The throw got away for the first baseman off the tarp area. Correa will get the second. What a blunder from KSU. Should have been an automatic. Now the Hatters have life. So officially a K, and Correa moving up the second. That will also be a throwing error on Nick Hassan. And now we'll see Correa leaving the game for a pinch hitter. Dylan Brazel will step in here. No surprise. Brazel, one of the fastest runners on this Hatters team. Also a guy who could potentially play in the outfield if needed, but that won't really matter since Correa was in the DH spot. Man, an absolutely shocking development there. It was a routine throw to first. That's all Nick Hassan had to do to get the strikeout. All of a sudden, Smith Pinson, through no fault of his own, is in the fire. Nick DiPonzio, for what it's worth, is one of the few Hatters to have any success offensively tonight. He's 1-for-3, triple in the second, his only hit. K looking in the fourth, grounded out to the pitcher in the sixth. And Pinson, for the first time all game has to worry about a runner on the bags. Outside, and that missed, according to home plate up, John Bennett, 1-0. DiPonzio, the potential winning run. DiPonzio yet to hit a home run this year, but he's done it before for Stetson. Swings right through the breaking pitch there. DiPonzio actually got Stetson's first win of the year, walk-off style in the bottom of the ninth against Delaware. Bags were full then, though, and that was a single with the bases loaded into right field. Something similar probably plates Brazel, or at the very least, means a play at the plate. Because I'm not sure of lots of things in life, folks, but I promise you this. If there's a single in the outfield, Dylan Brazel is coming home. For sure. The 1-1. And Pinson with a nice strike on the outside part of the plate. Ponzio, the former Wake Forest Demon Deacon. Who, by the way, is a Peach State native from Macon. Brazel diving back in. Pinson pretending like he was going to throw to second. One out on the board here. Hatters down one in the bottom of the ninth. But with a runner at second base, that could tie the game. The 1-2, and DiPazio's down swinging. Second punch out of the night. And now Stetson's hopes rest on the bat of a freshman. Andrew Estrella with two outs. Estrella, he's also had a rough day, like much of the Hatters, 0 for 3. Two punch outs. Popped out to the second baseman in the fourth inning. KSU one out away from securing the weekend series win and a potential chance at a sweep tomorrow. KSU also could extend their lead in the A-Sun East with a win. They're going to be in sole possession of first no matter the result tonight, but they got a golden opportunity to get ahead of Gulf Coast here, at least a little bit. Gulf Coast falling to Liberty today and yesterday, so Flames with a chance to sweep the Eagles right out of Lynchburg. Long look at second. Time called by Estrella. Pinson certainly taking his time now. I can understand that. It's a big spot for KSU. Looking at his card on his belt. The 1-0. And Estrella. Hard swing at the breaking pitch. Hatters with a golden chance here to make KSU pay for an error. But only if Estrella can get a hit. The 1-1. And he swings through that one. Hatters down to their final strike. One, two. And that's hit on the line towards third. Young is there to throw to first in time. And KSU hangs on for the win. Owls 3, Stetson 2. Smith Pinson gets the win. A brilliant performance from him at the end of the game. Christian Pregent solo bomb in the fifth. The last hit that Stetson would get. Outside of that throwing error from Nick Hassan to allow Correa to reach here in the bottom of the ninth. The Hatters were skunked for the remainder of the game. So no matter what happens tomorrow, KSU is going to have a successful weekend here at Melching. The question is, will it be a sweep or can the Hatters salvage one tomorrow? We'll find out. First pitch at 1 o'clock. We'll have it for you here on Hatter Vision. KSU grabbing the lead early in this one, 1-0 on an RBI single from Donovan Cash. Stetson would grab the lead briefly in the fifth. Connor Keel coming in to score on a rundown between first and second. Christian Pregent's solo bomb would make it 2-1. But KSU would get singles in the seventh and in the eighth to come away with the win. Josh Hatcher's RBI double to tie the game at 2 in the seventh. And then Hudson Mims' RBI single with the bases loaded is the difference in this game. We'll see you tomorrow at 1 o'clock for my cameraman Charlie Franklin and everyone else here on Hatter Vision. I'm Asad Bendy on final score. KSU 3, Stetson 2. KSU improves their conference record to 9-2. Hatters fall to 4-7, trying to avoid another home sweep from a conference opponent tomorrow at 1 o'clock. We'll see you then. Have a good night.